We're here with Jack Doubleday, and he's the official videographer for the Bosnian Pyramids Foundation in Visoka. So, what can you tell us about your experience? For the overall experience that you've witnessed there.
Well, from June 2014, for 16 months into 2015, I worked as the official videographer for Archaeological Park Foundation in Visoko, Bosnia. And that was for Dr. Semir Osmanagic, who is the discoverer of the Bosnian pyramids, as many of you know. Although Wikipedia wants to tell us that this is only a claim and not a fact. But the scientific community, the real scientific community, knows that there are pyramids and other ancient structures in Visoko, Bosnia. And we have documented this. I and many other videographers and photographers and scientists working in different disciplines have documented this over the period of 12 years since 2005, when Dr. Semir Osmanagic discovered the pyramids in Bosnia.
And you've been there since the start?
I was there as a volunteer in 2011, and I made some little videos with my little amateur camera. And Semir said, why don't you come back in 2014 as an official videographer with a really good camera and make some short scientific videos, 2.5 minutes each, on various aspects of the project, the megalith.
This was a megalithic site. It is megalith after megalith after megalith. Tens of them, maybe hundreds of them, over 30,000 years old. Now remember, I mentioned that below this megalith, there is underground water flow. And the width of the water is here from the left edge to the right edge. Also, on top of it, we can see like seven hills. Maybe it represents a relief, a topography. For the ancient builders, this was an information. They look at this megalith. They know that underground water streams is below us, that it's coming from this direction, going to that direction, and it is so wide with a certain strength. We took a sample from this block and sent it to Zagreb, Institute for Atomic Physics. We asked them a very simple question. Tell us if this is a natural block or artificially put together. So they applied two very sophisticated analyses. The first one was Röntgen diffraction analysis. The second one was phased analysis. And their conclusion was this was definitely a ceramic. 22 meters below us, underground water stream releases the energy. Energy activates the quartz crystal. It is surrounded by ceramic. Ceramic vibrates. And the vibration generates electromagnetic fields. 28 kilohertz and 7.83 hertz. For us in 21st century, this is just a piece of rock. And this is the difference between us and them.
The healing properties of Rovnik Tunnel.
We measured the concentration of negative ions. They raise the level of oxygen in our bodies. They kill viruses and bacteria. This year, June, July, the average is 42,000 negative ions per cubic centimeter. So, it means that somebody built underground healing facility. When we are on the surface of the planet, there are a lot of cosmic radiations. Some of them are bad for us. And our body cells fight those cosmic radiations. Inside the tunnels, 25 meters below the surface, no cosmic radiations. No enemies for our body cells. The values for Hartmann grids here, the tunnels, equal zero. For Curie's grids, zero. Schneider's grids, zero. In other words, the whole underground system is completely safe and secured. So the moment you enter the tunnels today, your body cells would not have enemies anymore. So they could start doing their job. What is their job? To fix the problems in our body. To start the regeneration process. To start the self-healing process. Our planet has been resonating at 7.83 Hertz for thousands of years. All the living beings, plants, animals, humans, we all resonate at 7.83 Hertz. And that's the best one for our intellectual and physical abilities. In science, it is called Schumann resonance. So it seems that somebody has designed and executed the pyramid complex in Bosnia as the guardian of the best frequency on the planet.
The energy phenomena in Robney Tunnel, like orbs and other things.
It's an active energy generating system. And it seems to me that it dates from a time where all of the Earth was actually more energetic.
This is the research that we're doing here in Visoko at the Pyramid Valley. The top area shows roughly our first week of being here, a group of three of us, and five different sections of research we wanted to understand about.
There's regular orbs, there's flash orbs that I call comet orbs. They appear very short in your footage and very flashy. There's needles, that is probably fast-traveling flash orbs. There's mists that travel as a conglomerate together. There's what I call guardians, huge, huge round mist shapes at the water holes. They appear only in the footage, you don't see the mist. And there's a purple beam that seems to be an activation of some sort. So this is what I call the purple beams or rays. It's definitely another light phenomenon than the orbing.
Volunteers, visitors have made over 10,000 photos that contain intriguing, perfectly spherical light beings, known in the spiritual science as orbs. They come in a variety of dimensions, from the little, small ones, tiny ones, to the big ones. One of the biggest ones that we did was about 40 centimeters in radius. We have noticed that they moved independently from the airflow. They changed directions, heights, speeds. We have also noticed that they usually go to the places where there is some action. For example, when we put the wooden support, they are like overviewing what we are doing there. Also, when our guides come with the tourists, they usually gather around the guides because he is the one who gesticulates, who talks, who shows. So we can see the signs of intelligence there.
The water in Robney Tunnel.
They did microbiological and chemical analysis. Their conclusion, the water was drinkable, healthy, no microbes. How is it possible? The high concentration of negative ions act as a barrier for the microbes. This water is alive energetically. It's beautiful because it has been exposed to the best electromagnetism, ultrasound frequency, good for the levitation, the Schumann resonance, negative ions, all the good stuff. And that's why this water is a good water.
The concrete on the Pyramid of the Sun. The four layers of concrete that cover the Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun. I got a camera specifically for Robney Tunnel because it's, as you might imagine, it's very dark in the tunnel. Mm-hmm. So you need, there is some lighting in there, but you need a good light sensitive camera. So that's what I bought. So it's a very filmic mm-hmm. quality to the footage in the tunnels. And if you want to experience something amazing, Robney Tunnel, which winds beneath the Bosnian Pyramid Complex in Visoko, Bosnia, is an amazing experience. They have excavated this fill-in material that was brought in 4,600 years ago, and little by little are excavating this gravelly, sandy material, this loose material, mm-hmm. And the volunteers are taking it out, and little by little they'll find a megalith on the side of the path, another megalith. And you say, well, it's just a big stone. Well, it's not. They're not stones. They're ceramic sculptures from the past.
They're immense. They're enormous.
They're enormous. And some of them are as big as a house, like megalith K5, ceramic sculpture K5 is as big as your living room or bigger. And so they were clearly poured there in place, not brought in mm-hmm. with slaves and ropes, but poured there by a sophisticated mm-hmm. culture. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And so you say, wow, this is just absolutely amazing. But they're not like a Roman, right angle square
antiquity thing. Or something. Yeah,
it's strange.
It's difficult
shapes.
To determine what it is, but
they're bizarre.
But they're pretty sure. The scientists are pretty sure that this was poured. There.
Well, they know certainly with 100% accuracy
yes.
that these are artificial ceramic sculptures, not natural rocks. And they're placed on sandstone plates to keep them exactly where they want to be.
Okay.
Now, the scientists have discovered that beneath these megaliths, every mm-hmm. single one of them, there are underground water channels that meet or diverge. Mm-hmm. So if there's a water channel that's going along underneath the tunnels and it hits something and diverges, bad energy is coming up. Mm-hmm. If there are two water channels that meet, bad energy is coming up. So the megaliths are set on top of these meeting places or diverging places of the water underneath, mm-hmm. and they are mitigating that energy.
They're acting as a buffer.
They're acting as a buffer between that energy and us. Whoever's in the tunnel does not want to experience the negative effects of these water channels.
This is very interesting.
It's fantastic.
Yes, very interesting.
The technology, the understanding, and then technology to put into play these incredible sculptures to help our health. Mm-hmm. And you say, well, our health. I mean, we're just visiting this place that was made by who knows what race of people in the past. It wasn't. Was it for us? Well, we don't know who it was for.
Frankie was telling me earlier this morning that there are several layers beneath these stones. There are some quartz crystals or something, he was mentioning something like that.
The stones are, the ceramic yeah. sculptures or the megaliths are placed on sandstone plates. So they're stuck to these sandstone mm-hmm. plates, clearly placed there.
Mm-hmm. You can clearly see this base.
The base, exactly. So we know that someone put them there or poured them there.
Poured them there.
And they're always to the side of the tunnel path. So the tunnel is winding around. It's a labyrinth. So there's all these branching tunnels, and you know, it's hard to know which ones to follow. And they're all filled with this filling material. And it's like, well, should we excavate this one or should we excavate this one? And that's the job of Dr. Sudmir Osmanagic, is to decide which one to excavate, because there's so many branching tunnels mm-hmm. filled with this filling material. So mm-hmm. as we excavate, as the volunteers and employees excavate, they see, oh, and they start to see a megalith on the side. Mm-hmm. And it's not in the middle of the tunnel, so we know it's not some random rock that just is sitting in the middle. It's always to the edge so we can get past it, and we're walking past them. So then the tourists come, and they have this beautiful, they walk past these amazing sculptures left and right, and then mm-hmm. they walk past a side tunnel that turns into a water channel. And some of these you can get, if you want to go in, you can see that they wind around, mm-hmm. they get deeper and deeper, mm-hmm. and then after 70 or 90 meters they stop. And you're like, well, why would the ancients create a water channel that winds for 70 or 90 meters and then stop? That mm-hmm. doesn't make any sense. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. But we know that they left the culture that filled in the tunnels left those open. So 90% of the tunnels were filled in. The main tunnel channel was filled in. Most of the side tunnel channels were filled in, but the ones with the water were not filled in. They were left open. They blocked the entrances to the water channels, mm-hmm. but they left the water channels open. And the water is drinkable, it's pure, it's medicine.
Videographer, you've been all around the place, you've seen everything. What is it like when you come to the top of the pyramid? What do you see from up there?
From the Pyramid of the Sun?
Yeah, what's the view like? What impression do you have when you're on top?
Well, the first thing you see is the Pyramid of Love right next door, and those two pyramids are knitted together by a clay and concrete staircase. It's not really a real staircase where it looks like it was made to walk up, but there it's alternating clay and concrete layers perfectly horizontal between those two pyramids that join them together on the southern side of the Pyramid of the Sun and the northern side of the Pyramid of Love. So it's like this really strong double twin pyramid structure. And from the tallest pyramid in the world, the tallest documented pyramid, the Bosnian Pyramid of the Sun, you can see the top of the Pyramid of Love, which is a smaller pyramid, mm-hmm. and it's a flat top, and you kind of wonder, was it always flat, or was there mm-hmm. once one of those quartz crystal capstones? Just like you wonder, was there once a beautiful capstone on the Pyramid of the Sun? And who took it and where did it go if there was?
What's about these capstones? Can you elaborate on
all this? Around the world, mm-hmm. you have this, the top of the pyramid's not there, and you kind of wonder, where is the top of the pyramid?
Okay.
And so the theory is that there were crystal tops to these pyramids all around the world that have been taken for their value or taken to keep people from knowing the power of the pyramids. Mm-hmm. And what is the power of the pyramids? Well, Semir Osmanagic in his doctorate dissertation said that it was to, one of the things that pyramids do is to communicate with other planets. Mm-hmm. So he's been saying that for decades, and he just got confirmation of scalar wave phenomena in the Bosnian pyramids mm-hmm. by Goran Majanovic's work. So they wrote an article called The Cosmic Internet.
What is the cosmic internet?
We've got scalar waves coming from the center of the galaxy is the idea. This is Ken Rolla's idea. And his video, The Physics of Consciousness, is a key video. And he talks about the propagation of scalar waves from the center of the galaxy. DNA is picking up the information in the scalar waves like antenna.
It's a communication system. It's a network. And it's not just a network within our bodies. You have to keep in mind that we are part of this galactic network. That's why we're all one. When you hear people talk about we're all one, it's not some woo-woo New Age concept. We are literally part of a gigantic galactic matter-energy system.
So DNA aren't the beginning of the information for life. He's saying that they're simply the antenna that's catching the information from the center of the galaxy, and that all these life forms are catching this incredible blueprint of information in the scalar waves. Now, what are scalar waves? Well, Tesla talked about standing waves, mm-hmm. scalar waves. This is Tesla's discovery that these waves, which are traveling at maybe billions of times faster than the speed of light, which is hard to believe, but this is what he's saying, would allow, and Semir Osmanagic and Goran Marjanovic are echoing Tesla's idea, would allow a cosmic internet to occur, because the billions of times faster waves would allow instant communication between one side of the galaxy and the other. It would be like calling your friend in the next house on a telephone. It's scalar wave technology, and our cell phones should use scalar wave technology. It shouldn't be microwave technology, because the microwaves are detrimental to our health. Scalar waves are not.
What are these waves? I've heard about gamma rays and all kinds of, but I'm not familiar with it. When you study the light spectrum and everything, where are they? There are cosmic rays and so, where are they in this scale?
I think that the best thing to do for anyone who wants to research this is to look at this article, The Cosmic Internet.
Okay.
It's really new, it's fantastic, it's absolutely mind-blowing information, and it will give you the scientific basis for the scalar waves. And then, if people want, they can research Tesla. He has so many things that he's discovered, but the scalar wave phenomenon is something that he talks about. So if we start with Tesla, and we get the general idea of what a scalar wave is, he brought the idea to the forefront, and then, mm-hmm. literally over a century later, Goran Marjanovic in the Bosnian Pyramid Complex comes along and says, I just detected scalar waves for the first time anywhere mm-hmm. in the Bosnian Pyramid Complex.
Incredible.
What are they doing there? Are the pyramids antenna for scalar waves? Mm-hmm. Are they propagating them and receiving them? Is that why pyramids were built? It's a question.
What does it have to do with the geomantic energy? Tesla also talked a lot about
the Earth energy.
Yes. Does it have a connection with the cosmos?
Semir talks about this all the time. He says that the pyramids are amplifying Earth energy. And the scientists around the world who are ignoring the Bosnian Pyramid Complex and ignoring Semir and ridiculing him are making a mistake. And they should take a moment to think about why the Bosnian Pyramids project is the most active archaeological project on the planet.
Yes.
About random things.
How's it going with the volunteers today?
Good.
good.
Dobro.
Dobro, super dobro. This group have done. Look at them. Look how much work.
Wow.
You need to take photos of this group. I think
let's do that. Have fun.
Thank you.
See you. Okay.
Every one of you take one wheelbarrows. Not everyone, that we don't have enough.
I'm
from Bosnia, but right now I'm living in Istanbul.
Nice, nice. And you?
I'm Michael. I live in Vancouver and I'm from Vienna originally.
Oh, nice. Why did you come here to volunteer at the Bosnian Film Festival?
Well, me, I want to experience something different than the usual life routine.
Keep an eye on the material as it's coming out, so if you see anything, you know, by eye,
yeah,
just pick it up. Because that's how I found the artifacts.
Yes, of course.
Okay.
So we uncovered like another piece, another big piece. Awesome. Everything that you see there is still dark.
Yeah.
That's all we did today, yeah. It's a few hours of digging. A few hours digging, you got about apparently 20,000-30,000 years of history right in this layer of soil.
Is it soil or is it clay?
It's clay.
Well, it's the inside of soil.
Right at the bottom.
Up until
soil and then it becomes clay, so.
So it's soil?
Soil and the very bottom part clay.
Soil then, you can see as it changes, the color becomes lighter brown, that's the clay.
Right, so the soil is the dark.
Yeah, at the top, yeah.
And then the clay is the lighter.
Yeah, exactly right.
So how many thousands of years do you think this concrete has been sitting under dirt?
Well, they found organic matter and they've dated it in the concrete itself. They found a leaf and they've analyzed it by two different institutes. And one was saying between 29,000 years, the other one 35,000 years. So between the two, plus minus 400 years. Not bad.
So this is the first time this concrete's seen daylight in 30,000 years?
Just
something
about,
like
yeah,
that?
Just about. Absolutely, yeah.
Cool.
Good stuff. History. History in the making. It's good to be part of it.
Huh?
Yeah.
I guess the new mankind is under a whole bunch of soil.
Yes. The new mankind is your old mankind.
We're just remembering what we used to know.
Say again?
We're just remembering what we used to know. Becoming aware again. More conscious.
I wonder how it is that we're remembering. Like, what's the way to remember who we are?
Ask the ancients, they knew. And they left a story for us.
Anything else on your experience? Did you experience something mystical when you were taking the videos? Something that you can tell us about your personal experience?
I didn't really need a mystical experience because it was already so mystical to realize that mountains, I mean, huge hills, were actually built pyramids. I mean, and that no one had known that for hundreds or thousands of years, and it took Semir Osmanagis to come along and say, those are pyramids, in 2005.
I overheard you talking with the girl before about the pyramids being alive.
Consciousness.
Consciousness? What about consciousness?
That pyramids have a consciousness.
So 2 years ago,
yes.
In 2015,
yes,
you said...
This was... 15, yeah.
What does 20. That say in English?
Semir Osmanagic, researcher from Bosnian pyramid, and me in discussion. I think that pyramids have a consciousness of the earth, not only the energetic aspect.
So you believe the pyramids are in some sense alive?
Of course they are.
But see, this is the first I've heard of this. I only hear
my
about,
prediction.
I only hear about them as energy machines. Now you're saying that Semir has come to the same conclusion.
Yes, of course. because he approved now that they helped to cosmic internet.
And what does it mean, a cosmic internet, to the people who don't know anything about the pyramids?
I think it's better you ask this, Samer.
Are you saying that the pyramids are communication devices?
Of course.
Between planets?
Between planets, but I think that there is something also more that we didn't discover yet.
Do you believe so?
She was the first one to come up with that, as far as I know, except that she said that Semir also is saying that. Tesla said the crystals are alive.
Yeah.
So if Tesla is telling us the crystals are alive, and we know that the pyramids have crystalline material in them, I mean, if crystalline material defines what pyramids are all around the world. So I think this crystalline material that Tesla said is living could be the key to what our friend was talking about, and what Semir Osmanagic and Goran Marjanovic, the electrical engineer, who's done research in the Bosnian pyramids, are saying about the pyramids being alive.
Thank you, Jock.
Thank you. Thank I you really appreciate much. It, Martin.
Thank you very much.
The Bosnian Pyramid Project is also a platform where scientists from different scientific disciplines meet. We want to encourage the exchange of the ideas, research, investigations, open-minded theory. And I know that many other projects are very close to such openness and such exchange of information between the scientists. We are not like that. The science is about knowledge, sharing the knowledge, staying open, because the knowledge belongs to all of us.